All right, so we'll bring that up in budget time. Borough engineers report, we have none. Solicitors report.
I don't have anything for the record. My ordinance, the LERTA ordinance, will be later in the agenda. Progress.
Thank you. All right, next up, we have four different ordinances. All of these are the second readings. So ordinance 1261, an ordinance of the Borough of Emmaus, Lehigh County, Pennsylvania, amending chapter 15, subsection.
1266.
Correct the number.
12, what did I say?
61.
1266, ordinance 1266. Amending chapter 15, subsection 210 of the Emmaus Borough Code, restricting left turns from Klein's Lane to Main Street during certain school hours. This is the second reading. Is there any discussion on
I'll make a motion though.
Make a motion? Mm-hmm. Motion by Ms. Bumgarner. Is there a second?
Second.
Mr.
Second.
Leibenberg? Any formal discussion? Mr. Brown?
I was just asked that we look into like an LED control device that could trigger at certain times and hours. That's all.
During that's live.
Yep.
That we could definitely bring up in public safety in our next meeting. We could discuss
that. I think
that
will assist with the signage. I think it will give a better visual.
Okay. Anything else? All right, this is going to be a roll call vote. Councilwoman Watt?
Aye.
Councilman Anders?
Aye.
Councilman Leibenberg?
Aye.
Councilman Honscheid?
Aye.
Councilman Brown?
Aye.
Councilwoman Bumgarner?
Aye.
Councilman Balliot? Aye. Thank you for that. I think that's going to help out over in that intersection a whole lot and hopefully cut down on some school traffic. Next up is ordinance 1267, an ordinance of the Borough of Emmaus, Lehigh County, Pennsylvania, amending chapter 24 of the Code of the Borough of Emmaus by adding a part 6, local economic revitalization tax assistance, providing for real estate tax exemption for new construction and improvements to deteriorated properties pursuant to the Pennsylvania Local Economic Revitalization Tax Assistance Act, and establishing standards and qualifications for obtaining such exemption. This is the second reading of this. Would anyone like to make a motion to approve? Mr. Brown, is there a second? Ms. Watt, is there any more discussion on this? This is has some adjustments, and I know that Jason can speak of this. Mr. Lindberg?
Just to verify, because I read it and I didn't see it, but it's probably there. The five-year renewal, I just wanted to make sure that...
It's 24605E lays out the five-year table.
What page? Do you know what page that is?
Here, I'm literally just going to hand it to you.
All right, but I want to make sure that's the same. Oh, that's on here.
Can I scroll down? Can I touch your computer?
Yeah.
There. 5 years.
But does it say that it renews every 5 years? Because
no,
that was the intent. Of the, no, that's the five-year LERTA. We had a motion last meeting that the ordinance is renewed every 5 years.
You called it a sunset.
I did not put a sunset in this.
So that's why I questioned it, because I did not see it. Yes, I know it's a five-year plan for the LERTA, and it reduces every 20% every year. I'm referring to the ordinance itself had a five-year reset that came up for a vote every 5 years.
There is no sunset provision in this as drafted.
So that was a motion, and it is in the minutes that was approved, I believe, 4-2.
If that's the case, then I believe we should re-advertise it, if that is what your intent is, to have the sunset provision, because this lasts in perpetuity.
It says the borough may, by ordinance adopted from time to time, extend the time for filing an application for
that's,
exception.
That's its existence. That's, okay, that's that not, would, that is not a sunset provision. I did not include that.
Okay.
If you go to the minutes of last meeting on page, oops. Mr. Ladenburg made a motion seconded by Councilman Anders. Establishing standards and qualifications for obtaining such exemption to include a 5-year sunset. There were 4 ayes and 2 nays. Motion carried.
That is indeed correct. This is wrong. I will add that back in. It will be re-advertised. It will have to be done that way if that is your intent.
So do we need to make a motion to table it then, or how do we deal with that?
You would table it right now, but we will have to re-advertise for the next meeting because there will be that change added.
You couldn't vote on it contingent upon that being added?
Because it wasn't advertised.
It wasn't advertised, and that is a significant enough change that you would have to do it.
Okay.
I apologize because I honestly thought that I didn't catch it in the minutes. In my notes, it was debated, and it was a 4-2 vote. It was not actually, but it was agreed upon. There was a correct vote on that. So it will be added in.
So I'll make a motion to table it until that's corrected.
Motion to table by Mr. Lindberg, seconded by Mr. Anders. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? 7. All right. So that ordinance we'll hit up next meeting. When will the next reading of that be? Because our next meeting is in 2 weeks. Is that enough?
It'll have to be advertised for the end of the month. End of the month meeting for September.
So that will be September
16th.
Yeah, September 16th. All right, next up is Ordinance 1268, an ordinance of the Borough of Emmaus, Lehigh County, Pennsylvania, amending Chapter 15, Subsection 209.1, restricting traffic from turning onto Howard Street from Long Street and establishing a no-through way on Howard Street. This is the second reading. Is there a motion to approve Ordinance 1268?
I'll make a motion.
Motion by Ms. Bumgarner. Is there a second? Mr. Ladenburg? Is there any further discussion on this from anybody? Hearing none, roll call vote. Ms. Watt?
Aye.
Mr. Anders?
Aye.
Mr. Ladenburg?
Aye.
Mr. Hunshad?
Aye.
Mr. Brown?
Aye.
Ms. Watt? Or Ms. Bumgarner?
Aye.
And Mr. Balliot? Aye.
You get
7 ayes. That passes. And then we have next up is Ordinance 1269. An ordinance of the Borough of Emmaus, Lehigh County, Pennsylvania, amending Chapter 15, Subsection 602.3.a of the Emmaus Borough Code, revoking a residential permitted disabled parking space and assigning a new residential permitted disabled parking space on the public street located in front of 38 North 6th Street within the Borough of Emmaus. Also, the second reading. Is there a motion to approve Ordinance 1269? Mr. Hunshad, is there a second?
Second.
Mr. Ladenburg, is there any further discussion? Hearing none, roll call vote. Ms. Bumgarner?
Aye.
Mr. Brown?
Aye.
Mr. Hunshad?
Aye.
Mr. Ladenburg?
Aye.
Mr. Anders?
Aye.
Ms. Watt?
Aye.
Mr. Balliot? Aye. 7 ayes. Thank you. Under new business, this is going to be the first reading of Ordinance 1270, an ordinance of the Borough of Emmaus, Lehigh County, Pennsylvania, amending Chapter 15, Subsection 602.3.a of the Emmaus Borough Code, amending the residential disabled parking sign and assigning a permitted parking spot on the public street located in front of 224 Adrian Street, within the Borough of Emmaus. This is the first reading. Is there a motion to approve Ordinance 1270?
So moved.
Ms. Bumgarner, seconded by Ms. Watt. On the discussion on this, this was a handicap spot that was already there, and it was just it's going to be a permanent named spot. So if everybody has any more questions on that, hearing none, roll call vote. Mr. Leibenberg?
Aye.
Mr. Brown?
Aye.
Mr. Honshad?
Aye.
Mr. Anders?
Aye.
Ms. Watt?
Aye.
Ms. Bumgardner?
Aye.
Mr. Balliot? Aye. 7 ayes. Unfinished business part 2. We have none. Does anyone have an item not on the agenda to bring up? Hearing none. Madam Mayor's report.
Thank you. Just one item for everybody to know. We did officially receive reaccreditation for the department. We're now 33rd, I believe, in the state, because we also received premier agency status. So Mr. James Adams from the accreditation coordinator, he will be here on September 16th to present the certificate and plaque. So I'll report progress.
Awesome. Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Mr. Brown?
I just want to add on to Madam Mayor's comments. Not only did we get premier accreditation, we also assist Delaware County government with the Sheriff's Department to get accreditation as well. So I want to thank our accreditation people to also assist other agencies, such as Delaware County.
That's great. Next up is committee reports. Public Works, Mr. Anders.
Thank you, Mr. President. We have several items for official business this evening. The first is the GAC vessel purchase. And this is a purchase, this is to purchase the vessels themselves for the PFAS treatment. It does take a long time for this to come in. It's about a year, depending on their order load. But in as an overview, it is a CoStars purchase through the Calgon Carbon Corporation in the amount of $848,870. The bid is over $100,000 less than the next closest, nearly $2 million less than the third. The funds to pay for this will be from our $1.1 million in ARP money that we have saved. So with that, I would like to put in the form of motion to purchase the GAC vessel item.
Motion by Mr. Anders. Is there a second?
Second.
Mr. Leibenberg, is there any further discussion? Mr. Leibenberg?
Just that I talked to Shane and I asked, what did we originally expect this to be? And he said they expected around $1 million. So it's kind of good news that it's a little lower than that.
Great. I know that there was a lot of discussion going on in this and the lead times. Roy, do you remember what the lead times were on these tanks?
It does say at least a year.
About a year.
Yeah.
That's a long time. Any more discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? 7 ayes.
Our next item is we held interviews for Public Works. And first, I want to acknowledge the individuals who sat in for me. My co-counsel here and Chris and Brent for being here as I was traveling. Kate and did many interviews along with Christine. Christine actually set us up. We had Christine, how many applicants for this position? This positions? Kristen, excuse me.
Yes.
How many applications did we have? I said Kristen and I said it wrong.
Total?
Yeah.
Over 350.
Over 350. That's phenomenal. So we got two to hire this evening, and we will still be hiring for one other position. The first is Charles Welsh from Brynansville, PA. And this will be contingent upon him successfully passing his background check. And I'll put that in the form of a motion to hire.
Motion by Mr. Anders.
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Leibenberg. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Oppose? 7 ayes.
Our second individual we will be hiring, her name is Taylor. And I want to say
Ransaforte.
Thank you. I've heard wonderful things about Taylor and that she'll be a great fit for our department. So I will put that in the form of a motion again after completing successfully the background check.
Second.
Second. Motion by Mr. Anders, second by Mr. Leibenberg.
Mm-hmm.
Any further discussion? Mr. Hunshine?
I just want to say I'm really excited about both of these individuals. The interviews went very well, and I think they're both going to be great additions to the department.
That's great. Mr. Leibenberg?
I concur. During the interview process, I think their attitude came through, and that's what we're looking for, people that want to contribute and be hard workers.
That's great. Anything else?
It's my understanding this is the first woman that's been worked for Public Works. Is that accurate?
That is correct.
That's exciting.
Right? Yes, it is. Ever.
Wow.
Just as thinking.
That's way cool.
It's a big deal.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? Seven ayes.
We did not meet due to my travel restrictions, and unfortunately next month's meeting, I am traveling, but I'm going to ask that the committee still meet to discuss several issues, just as was brought up this evening with the roads and some future other issues, including hiring over the next person. So that meeting is September 9th at 4:45 p.m., and with that, I'll report progress.
Thank you, Mr. Anders.
May I ask a quick question?
Yes. Sure.
For Taylor, is there going to be space set up for a locker?
Yes.
And will that be able to
accommodate? Yes.
Accommodate her soon?
Yes, that was part of our discussion.
Okay. Thank you.
Great question, though.
All right, next up, we have health, sanitation, and codes. Mr. Brown.
All right, thank you, Mr. President. Nothing for official action tonight. Our next meeting is tomorrow at 4:45. I do want to bring everybody up to date on the zoning ordinance. We are going to probably push that back now until December. So the reason is at CRD, as we are collaborating with CRD with in regards to different topics, and that one topic is design standards. And during the discussion with CRD, we found that there are some, like non-relating from the zoning ordinance and the saldo are not matching up. So there, we got some work to do to clean up before we present the product to full council. It's not ready yet. So I know I sent an email out knowing that there is some maybe fatigue with the zoning ordinance, but hopefully we can, we now, because of CRD and the design standards, we were able to catch this. And we were able to take this opportunity now to cross the finish line. So we'll have something for a full council here shortly, probably around, like I said, December, maybe end of November. Progress.
Awesome. Thank you, Mr. Brown. Next up is Parks and Recreation. Mr. Hunshad.
Thank you, Mr. President. One item first for official action. Last month, we discussed Charlie's second annual charity fishing derby event. Based on recommendation of the committee, council voted to deny that request. Shane since has spoken to another individual, got some clarification. Number one, that it will be catch and release. They're not going to be selling alcohol. It's just going to be a BYOB event. So with that additional information, the committee is comfortable with moving forward to allow them to have that event. It's going to be on a much smaller scale than they originally stated. So we are okay with that. We still do plan to discuss either policy or ordinance regarding public fishing derby events. But for this one, we're pretty confident that this should be okay. So I'm going to put it in the form of a motion pending them getting insurance, that we do allow them to hold that fishing derby event coming up.
A motion by Mr. Honscheid. Is there a second? Mr. Yeah. Leibenberg? Discussion? Mr. Leibenberg?
I saw in the communication that they had done this previously. That said last year. Was that at a different location?
Yes, it was.
And how many attended that event? Do you know?
Shane mentioned that, and I think
in the,
it's
in the letter
similar,
it says around 50. Okay. If you read that letter, right?
It's in the letter.
Yeah, we had around, it says we had around 50 people and only about 20 responded. So they expect it'll be on that same scale.
Thanks.
Mr. Lambert?
Yeah, this is more for my education. For our borough pond there, the Furnace Dam, is it still regulated where they need a fishing license to fish there?
Yes.
Yes.
So can we please convey that to them, that the people that are entering the contest, that they still have their license?
Could add that to the motion.
Oh, the kids don't need it, but the adults do. I didn't make the motion. I seconded it.
Yeah, I mean, that's state. That's a state law. So I don't know that it
I'm
would
just,
be
necessary.
Not necessarily for us to
saying they have to have it.
The borough can't supersede the state law anyway. So they would have, they'll be required to do that regardless.
I'm just more or less saying, can we just put one sentence in there to remind them that they should have a license? That's all. I'm not requiring it or anything. Nobody's going to be there checking them.
But I think
they should know that they should have a license to participate.
Somebody could amend the motion to say include, and subsequently amend the motion to include reference that they must comply with all state and federal law, state, federal, and local law.
That's not my intention. My intention is just to put a sentence in there to make sure they have a license. That's all.
Are we amending a motion? Would you like to?
I don't even know if we need to have it in the motion. If we know and we're informing them, just let them
right.
Know
if make Lincoln sure speaks to them, just to kind of give them that reminder.
Yeah, that's all I'm asking.
Perfect, Mr. Anders.
And as Chris had mentioned, we still don't have an insurance. So until we have that, I mean, it's even though we give approval, they still have to provide that.
Correct. Yeah. Any other discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Oppose? 7 ayes.
The only other thing that I wanted to mention, everything else is in the meeting notes, the Recreation and Entertainment Commission, and I know I say this often, still could desperately use some additional volunteers. So if anyone on council knows any individuals in or around the community, or if anyone watching this recording has an interest in joining the Recreation and Entertainment Commission, please speak to me or someone else on council. We can get you in touch with the right people.
Mr. President?
Yes, sir.
The other thing was that we had discussed, and the Laura Street Playground should be, it may even be built now. They were waiting on one part to come in. It was supposed to come in, and it may be there and set up, which is kind of exciting for the residents over there.
That's great. I was talking to a few of the public works workers that have been here for a long time, and they were telling me that's the first new park in at least 30 years that was installed in the borough. You think that's accurate?
No. Furnace Dam had gotten new equipment not long ago, and Community Park had
Arch Street,
and even down at William Street, that's been
I didn't think that was,
unless it was that because they install our public works department installed.
Maybe
this
that's
one,
what
so
they're
maybe
referring
that's what
to.
It
maybe because a lot of times it sounds like it might have been outsourced or we hired.
Correct.
Maybe that's what.
Yeah, maybe. But it's exciting to see that, and that was something that we had promised the residents last year, and I know Shanna was the leading on that and working with the residents. They came here, we partnered with them, and it's a success. So great job to all on that.
Any consideration in maybe having like a grand opening park party or something like that one evening?
It hasn't come up. That's certainly something that we can discuss. Yeah.
Cool.
And as far as the pool and community park, it's been a fantastic summer for the pool, record-breaking by all accounts. And again, there's some information in the meeting notes. We're still looking at Lions Park. Some news came in as far as additional work that's going to have to be done that's going to affect the scope and cost of that project. But we're still working, so I will report that our next meeting is September 19th at 4:45, and I'll report progress.
I thought Shanna had her hand first.
Oh, I was just going to piggyback off of what Mr. Anders said and commend Shane as well, because he worked very closely with the community members and made sure that what equipment went in there was serving the people of that neighborhood and what their interests were. So they worked together for many months to make that happen. So I appreciate everybody involved.
Awesome. Thank you. Next up, public safety, Ms. Bumgardner.
Thank you, Mr. President. And thank you, Mr. Balliet, as well for chairing public safety in my absence this month. All items that require action were already taken care of earlier, so we have no other items requiring action for public safety. Our next meeting will be September 11th at 9 a.m. in person and via Zoom. Report progress.
Thank you. General Administration, Mr. Leibenberg.
We have not met since last meeting, and our next meeting is actually this Wednesday at 9 a.m., and I report progress.
Thank you. Up next is Budget and Finance. In this committee, there is two action items. First up, for Council's consideration, we got a presentation from a company called Waterworth. And what they do is they compile all of our all of the expenses and stuff like that, and really help us calculate short term and long term water rates. I think that their program is fairly intuitive. It seems like we'll be able to provide them with all of the financial information needed, and I think that this would be a good thing to get, so we're not just picking numbers when it comes to setting water rates, especially with the PFAS coming in, the things going on with LCA and whatnot. Like, we're looking at, you know, a couple million dollars worth of expenditures that we're going to have to be able to calculate out. So I would look for a motion to approve the software purchase. Motion by Mr. Leibenberg.
Yeah, I'm going to say the cost. Let me bring it up first. For a price of $4,984, and it's from August 29th to December 31st of this year.
Thank you. Is there a second?
A second.
Second from Ms. Bumgardner. Questions?
So the only question I have is, because when we originally discussed this, we were talking about a 1 to 2, maybe even a 3-year plan. And the more years you got, the reduced rate per year you got. And but it was going to start next year, so we would have budgeted for next year. Since it's this year, my only question is, where's the money coming from?
That's what I was going to ask, actually.
And I didn't hear any, you know, Shane gave us some notes because he's not here, and that was not in there.
That was not in there. I mean, we could,
and I don't know if we need to, I don't think we need to approve it tonight. Maybe we can approve it next meeting, but it would change the date.
I don't think 2 weeks would. I don't think
it just changes the date by 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Just needs to be tabled.
So I guess if someone would want to make a motion to table this so we have a little bit more information, we could do so.
I'll make a motion to table it.
All right. Motion by Mr. Leibenberg to table. Is there a second?
Mr. Balliet, I know that Shanna had her hand raised previously, and I didn't want to. If she had a comment, I think she should be heard.
I think since there's a motion because of table, I don't think we can discuss anything any further.
Technically speaking, Mr. Balliet is correct. The motion to table actually takes precedence over all other motions.
My apologies. I know that she did have her hand up.
That said, the council president could allow discussion if he wants to grant her deference of the floor.
Sure.
The motion itself takes precedent. You can allow discussion.
Which might go towards your reason for tabling it. But my question had been, it wasn't clear whether there was an automatic renewal, like if we automatically would have the next year on our need for budgeting and what that cost would be, because it says it goes up by 4.something%. So that was one question. The other thought was there would likely be some training required for this, and I would imagine that would have to happen fairly soon, especially if we want it to be useful for budget season. So that was just a point I was going to bring up.
So I'll state that we were looking at a 1-year program, and then if we wanted to, we could skip a year and do another year after that, because we're not sure if we need it every year. So no, we're not tied into renewing it automatically.
So right now it's 4 months.
Yeah, it's the dates that were stated here.
Not necessarily next year.
Correct. Okay. But we could still do that if we find during those 4 months That is very, very helpful. We could budget it for the next year then. And I think that's why the company wants to kind of do this 4 months, because they know we'll probably end up going with it. It is very efficient and saves a lot of time for Shane.
Do they offer training for free?
There's a lot of one-on-one training that if you look at on the proposal, that one-page proposal, it tells you all the things that they provide. And
I would note for everybody on council, if you look at the actual quote here, it does indicate that invoices need to be sent or notices need to be sent 60 days prior to the end of the year to let them know if you are not going to renew. Right. So that puts you into the end of October.
Right.
Just for everybody's knowledge, when you do choose this, I'm sure Mr. Pepe will say the same at the next meeting when the tabling is done.
If you just look at page one of the quote, there's a bunch of bullet points, and that's all the things that are included.
Yeah, okay. I read it.
All right, there's still a motion to table. Is there a second? Nobody wants to second the table?
I want to vote on it.
Even though you don't know where the money's going?
It's $5,000. Shane could actually spend that without our...
If there's no second, the motion to table will die.
Okay. Second? No second. So we'll go back to the original motion.
All right. Well,
to approve
discussion then.
Is that how that? Do we have to make another motion?
No, you're no. It's still on the table. The Leibenberg/Baumgartner motion is still on the table. You can open it back up to discussion.
All right. Back open for discussion, Mr. Leibenberg.
So I'm just going to say I'm not going to vote for it because we don't know where the money's coming from. If I knew where the money was coming from, I support it. I mean, I support it from the get go, but I usually like to know how we're paying for it.
So,
Mr. Anderson?
And I'm not going to speak for Shane here, but I would assume he has a plan and there is some money within one of the funds for software that this would cover. And I do believe, isn't that even under the threshold that he could even spend that without council's approval?
This is below the bid threshold.
So,
pursuant to Title VIII.
Yeah. To me, I know that Shane would not put it somewhere in some wonky place in the budget, and I would believe that he feels that this is within it. We're saying $5,000, and I know it's not. I mean, so that's a lot of money to some, but it's in the grand scheme of our budget and where we are, that is a small thing. And if it can get it started, I think we approve it.
Yeah, my comment on it was I think it's a small amount of money to pay for fairly sophisticated software, as long as we feed it the proper information that, you know, as we're talking about borrowing, you know, millions of dollars, and that could definitely get sideways pretty quick on water rates. So to me, I think this was a drop in the bucket compared to, you know, what we could do as making a mistake if we don't calculate the process out. Any further discussion?
Yeah, I think this is... I was a little bit more on the fence about spending the $15,000 to have help one budget season out from now. But I think spending $5,000 and having it immediately, so one of the main points of the presentation is how getting your rates wrong is a problem that builds over time. And so if we can pay $5,000 and get our rates right this year, we'll either reap enormous benefits from that right away, or we'll find out that we don't need to spend $15,000 next year. I think this is a surprisingly good deal they're offering us. If we were interested in doing it for that $15,000, this is better, in my opinion.
Great. Any other discussion? All those in favor, say aye.
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 Oppose?
No.
Mr. Leibenberg opposes. 6-1. All right. Thank you for that. Attached is the July.
We still have resolution 24-20.
I do. Yeah, I'm still going through it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, I'm still giving my report. The July 2024 budget performance report is attached. Also, the significant revenue and expenses for the first half of August. And our next action item here would be resolution 2024-20, and that is our bill list. And it is as followed. The bill list is $1,015,783.20, We have payrolls 15 and 16 for the amount of $426,393.30. Payroll taxes of $135,509.57 for a total of $1,577,686.07. And that I will put in a form of a motion to approve the bill list. Is there a second? Ms. Watt? Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Oppose? Our next meeting will be on September 4th at 11. I think for our committee at that point, we will be discussing possibility of switching some banks. I know that we went out for the RFP and there was a couple of banks that responded back. So I think we'll have some great discussion on that. And then we also have, I think later in that week, I think we have interviews set up to go through with all that. So we'll be a little bit busy there. And if no one has any questions, I'll report progress. Community relations planning and development, Ms. Watt.
Well, we've already appointed the two members to the Historical Commission. And I just wanted to thank all of the volunteers and say that we expect in September to get the Historical Commission up and running. And it's something we're all really excited about. Our next meeting is Tuesday, September 10th at 5 p.m. And with that, I report progress.
Thank you. There are three sets of minutes for the different boards and commissions attached for everybody. Personal appeals part two. I don't see anybody online. Is there anybody in the audience make another appeal? Hearing none. Borough manager's report.
Hello, good evening, everyone. So the first announcement is a group leader promotion for Robert Leach as the new group leader for the streets section of the Public Works Department. Robert is a very experienced business owner, and he is excelling in the Public Works Department. He has a great deal of experience managing people, as well as a great deal of experience with project management. And we are excited to announce Mr. Leach as the new group leader in Public Works Department. Also, we have two recommendations for... Two recommendations. The first one is for Matthew Bockert to advance to class four in the Public Works Department. And there is a vote required for this one.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Labenberg to promote Matthew Bockert, and then seconded by Mr. Anders. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? Seven ayes.
And the second recommendation is also in the Public Works Department for Tyler Llewellyn to also advance to class four in the Public Works Department, and a vote is required.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by
well.
Mr. Labenberg, seconded by Mr. Anders to promote Tyler Llewellyn. Discussion?
Just a quick comment that both individuals I know work very hard over there, and through the new process, not really new process, but the process for them to advance, it's been great for our employees, and seeing these two individuals take the additional courses to get to the next level is great for us. It's great for our residents. They can do more, and they're more flexible for the department. So congratulations to both of them. Thank you.
Great. Anyone else? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? Seven ayes.
That completes the borough manager's report. Thank you.
Thank you. Under president's business, I would just ask that Shane sent out an email maybe like a week ago about getting us set up with that budgeting program. Make sure everybody gets logged in on that and starts understanding how to use that. If you're having any issues, what's it called?
ClearGov.
ClearGov?
Yes.
Who would they reach out to if they have a problem getting signed in?
Shane.
Yeah. So reach out to Shane if you guys have any issues getting signed in, but I think that's going to be a very important process.
Has anyone else received the email on how to log into that? I got Shane's email, but I don't have anything with credentials.
I did not get an email with credentials, nor was it in my spam box either.
I did. So maybe you got one last year and so you didn't get one this year?
Hmm. We did have it last year, and I yes. remember starting it once. So I'll have to.
There was a new email that was sent out by Shane recently.
Yeah,
I can make sure that Shane sends a new email out to all borough council members.
That might help.
Okay,
I like I said, I know I previously. Now that you mention it, we did have something last year, but we didn't really use the software, so it
was go back in the archived emails.
Yeah,
great. And then the next thing would be just be mindful that it is coming up on budget season to make sure that everybody's agenda, you know, includes any kind of, you know, budgeting time that anyone, department heads and stuff like that, want to do any kind of presentations or anything like that. We have no executive session. Is there a motion for adjournment?
So moved.
Ms. Bumgarner, seconded by Mr. Honshad. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? Nice. Meeting adjourned at 6:57.
You went faster than I thought. I think it'll be about an hour and a half.